Red McCraith, sir. I'm trying to help your wife, Prudence.
Whisper not to me, you devil.
Must we do this every single time?
You take the lead, then.
All right, let's banish it.
Be gone, devil! You'll not have her!
Why the coded messages? What were you trying to say?
The devil's whispers will come back. Forever she must flee. She must flee!
Why would the whispers come for her too, Thomas? Why aren't you telling us?
Why are you here? Why aren't you running? Why isn't Prudence gone already?
She'll listen if she hears it straight from you. Spoken plainly, mind you.
No, no, not I. Not like this.
When did the nightmares begin?
No beginning, never ending. Let the whispers end forever. Let the whispers end. Let them end.
Was there a face behind the voice, or a dark figure floating over you, perhaps, draining your life away?
No, no, not but what we are, the creatures we all truly are, buried in the darkness.
Did you take a sleeping draught? A remedy, perhaps? Did Prudence give you something?
Give? She gave me everything. I kept it. And I gave it back.
Prudence is not who you thought she is, and yet you kept her secret.
I know her. I love her.
Even after she betrayed the colony, even knowing she lied to you.
Perfect love cast death out fear, because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. I promised to love her. A promise should be kept.
You're killing her, Thomas.
No. No, you're wrong!
You're leeching the essence from her. She'll go insane, then she'll die.
She needs me! She needs me! She needs me!
He protects her. He just wants to keep her safe.
So we banish him. Then she'll be safe. Whatever we do, Prudence has the right to know what's happening. We should tell her. Stay here. Maybe we can help.
What are you doing here? Who exactly were you? You're talking to?
Who?
Me?
Just now, you were talking to someone. Who was it?
It's ridiculous. I'm alone here.
Don't play with me, Banisher. Now tell me the truth.
I'm sorry. I must press you further on your husband. Thomas had bad dreams, did he not?
I do not wish to talk about it, and I am very good at not talking about things.
He died a horrible death by all accounts. Forgive me, but that pain, that fear, it must linger.
Of course it lingers. I loved him and he died. He's gone, and I remain.
Clarity can be painful. We resist it. Lay it out plain for her.
I understand he suffered from terrible nightmares. Did you seek help? A physician, perhaps?
Of course we did. Nobody helped. Nobody could help.
Perhaps you wished for a banisher.
Perhaps. But if wishes were horses, beggars would ride.
At the siege of Vienna, we hanged wreckers. Mess with our grub, we'd gut you first. Aye. I found your secret code.
You. You left those messages. What do you want?
Not I. A ghost. And I'd like to know why.
I don't know what trick you're playing here, but I don't like it. I'm leaving. Don't get in my way, Scotsman.
Wherever you go, your ghost will follow.
Leave me be.
She's a tough nut. She won't crack until she has no other choice.
I can tell you the truth, but can you accept it? You rarely sleep. You wake exhausted. You feel drained, but blame it on the grief of your loss and the fear of your exposure.
What do you know of me and my life?
I know you're a spy. And I know your husband loved you very much. He found your cipher. His ghost writes upon your walls.
There is no ghost here. What are you up to?
Though Thomas may wish to protect you, his presence puts you in danger. He thought I was a threat to you. He tried to chase me away. He loves you very much, which is why he won't leave you alone.
Is he here? Is Thomas here?
He is. He wants you away from New Eden, away from danger.
I miss him every day.
I know you do. Prudence, Thomas, it's time. Thomas Hake, you met a tragic end. But, despite her lies, you lingered to protect the woman you love.
My dearest Prudence, will she be safe without me? Will she live in peace?
She's heard your warning. Now let her go. Let her live her life her own way.
Please, tell her. Her love was ever enough.
She knows.
They have been heard. Farewell.
Was he here? What happened? What did you do to him?
Thomas found peace. He wished you to know that your love was enough.
Please. I need a moment. Alone.
Broussard lost his mind, but his love held fast.
I can relate to that.
So?
I've done my rounds, as you ask.
And?
I found two hauntings in camp. Fixed them both.
Two? Really?
There are likely more. But those two, at least, are ended.
All right. So, I'll thank you kindly, Mr. McWraith. You've done your part and earned your place. My sister should soon return. She'll surely want to meet you. Until then, you may stay.
I'll take my leave.
I do.
Kate came by. Thickskin is back and wants to see you.
Why did she not wake me?
Perhaps she resented playing the messenger. Perhaps she just wanted to make you late. She was vexed. Thickskin return has upset her.
Kate reminds me of my sister.
Aoife.
Clan MacRaith's little Spitfire. Always at my heels. We're giving father's guards all kinds of hell. She was a wee thing, but strong. We big men in armor didn't scare her. She had more brains than her, and more wild too. In sparring, she'd beat me handy. She would have made a fine swordswoman, had she grown.
I've never met my brother and sister.
Wait, what?
Twins. By my mother's letters, they must be 8 years old.
You never told me this.
You never asked.
What are their names?
Ugh.
What? I'm interested, that's all.
You're bothersome. Ayomide is my sister. Tammy is my brother.
I'd no idea you got letters from home.
My mother writes once a year. The letters take months to find me, if they find me at all. Until now, I've given it little thought.
3 Duarte children walk the world. God help us.
Good boy. Now that you can count to 3, we can move on to 4.
I hope the twins have more charm than you do.
Did I mention Thickskin was waiting for you?
All right, I'm going.
Lull, the halfpenny redeemer come to save us. Thou may enter, O great savior.
Excuse my sister.
Underestimating her would be a mistake. She's tougher than you.
You're alive.
Long story short, you had an angry ghost in your meeting house. It was fierce. I fell in the sea. And Thea died.
Your loss pains us, but a good hunter should know when they've become the hunted.
Where lies the future for you? For the camp? For the people here?
The plan was to walk across the mountains, but the cold put an end to that. For now, we stay.
Till the weather lifts.
The weather and the fear. They must feel the sun on their faces again and courage in their hearts.
Who would not wish to feel the sun upon their face once more?
Is there news from New Eden Town?
When you went to the meeting house, I gathered me flock and left. I've heard nothing since.
Your faith in us gladdens my heart.
I wasn't wrong, was I? But folk here still believe in you.
What became of those who stayed?
Dead, or near it. I'm neither foolish enough nor mad enough to go find out.
She thinks you a madman, or a fool.
Maybe I'm both.
Don't crow. Foolish madmen abound.
What about the missing group of refugees?
What about them?
Kate told me they went missing before reaching your camp. Any chance they survived in the woods?
Not the slightest. Otherwise, they would already be here. Those poor bastards are long dead.
You didn't ask me here to watch you drink soup. What do you want?
Kate says you have metal. I can use that. There's a service I need from you.
You've something important needs doing and you want me to do it? No wonder your sister's fuming.
Kate may wish her skin were thick as mine, but wishing will not make it true.
Being the youngest can be a burden. Double when your big sister is the chief.
I'm no chief. I keep my head, that's all. For this, folk look to me.
Speak frankly. What would you have me do?
Banish a ghost that doesn't exist. Folk here believe in monsters. The fear makes them weak. Kill the beast. Kill their fear and give them back their strength.
Fear can be good.
We can't spare much, but you shall have a gun and powder and shot with it.
You know the curse is real. Why not the beast too?
The beast is nothing much. A bear, perhaps a wolf. A monster only in the mind.
Why not kill it yourself?
Because when the banisher kills the beast, everyone here will believe the monster dead.
'Tis honest work. I presume you'll pay for it.
I have the means to pay you. My word on it.
We'll see how that goes.
I'll hunt your beast, whatever it is. If you answer one last wee question.
You may ask it.
What's with the name? No one rightly calls their daughter Thick Skin.
My birth name be best forgotten. Thick Skin better suits the world.
Fair enough.
In the wild, we carry muskets. And we carry these. Whistle for help if the need be great.
And the gun?
My sister can spare her musket. If you can get it from her.
Kate will be delighted.
Kate will be hurt. I predict fireworks.
She cares. It's a good thing.
Or a dangerous thing.
Don't you have business elsewhere? Go, save us all from the beast. Go do my sister's char work.
I need a musket. Thick skin said I should have yours.
You'll rot in hell first, and so will she.
This should be good.
Are you so desperate to prove her wrong that you forget your own interest? You can climb your sister's pedestal or stamp your feet like a child, but neither serves you.
What do you know of sisters?
Enough to wish I'd not lost mine.
I can't leave camp unarmed. She traps me.
There's pain behind the anger. I doubt you'll blunt her temper.
Measure your worth by your own mark. Your sister's estimation shouldn't matter.
It matters. I do great work here, but my bull-headed sister won't see it. Thick skin measures worth by metal. The strong will live and the weak will die. She chose you to hunt the beast with my musket. She doesn't have to say a word about what she thinks of me.
I'll bring you back your gun. I swear on it.
You won't make it to New Eden Town without a gun. And we both know it.
I'm sorry. I wish there were another way.
As do I, Scotsman. You may have the gun. Now be so kind as to leave me be. Flint's a little tired, but she strikes fine. Unlike some, she won't go off half-cocked.
I'll take good care of her. And she of me, no doubt.
Oh.
sure the treasure is nearby. Good day to you.
And what can I do for you, sir?
Our things, Mr. Carthy. The old life is a memory long forgotten, I take it.
Not forgotten, no. Those memories remain, but they're comfortable. I can miss home without wanting to go back. I'm Irish. Did you know that? I came to London young. Fell in with a gang of pickpockets. The Wet Boot Boys. Called ourselves. Anyway, I did that for a while. Some of the boys' hands, some picked the wrong pockets and ended up in the river. Me, I was good at counting. Got a job at a counting house. It was good, well, good enough. But old habits die hard. Once a thief, you know.
Well, you're here now.
Aye, and with a clean slate too. And I'll be keeping it that way. New world. New offer.
How are things? How's Nelly?
She's good. Things are good. Funny. I never had a sister. I think I do now. Nelly's sweet and kind and don't judge. Past is the past, she says. I will never be grateful enough to her. She's my family in this new world. Listen to me, prating on like a Lambeth fishwife.
What's the good word round here? Or the bad, for that matter?
What would you like to know?
What are your thoughts on thick-skinned Newsmith?
She leads us well enough, but she should listen to her sister. She's headstrong. It's not good for folk. There's a beast in the woods. People are afraid. I'm afraid. We need protection.
What can you tell me of Kate Newsmith?
You know something? When I was a boy, my parents fought all the damn time. Couldn't wait to get away from them. Kate and thick-skin remind me of my parents. I can't wait to get away from them. But there's a beast in the woods, isn't there?
Tell me about life in the camp, if you would.
I really have to thank you. You're a man who knows how to keep a secret. I'm getting the hang of this smithing, Lark, so there's a future for us here. Thanks to you, Nelly and I are ready to start our new life in the new world. Horrible beast in the woods, notwithstanding.
I'll take my leave.
Farewell, Banisher.
Good day, Nelly.
All the better for your presence, Mr. McCrae.
How goes it, Mrs. Heaton?
Times are hard for everyone, but me. I've never felt so free. I'm almost ashamed of it. Almost.
Freedom is good. What do you plan to do with it?
You know, once, before I was unlucky enough to meet Fortune Heaton, I was a herbalist. Maybe I'll go back to that.
A healer could be useful. Especially if by healing others, she heals herself.
Wise words. Thank you.
Let's trade, Mrs. Eden.
All right, let's.
Thank you for your time, Mrs. Eden.
Thank you for your interest, Mr. McCraith.
The more I know Thickskin, the more I like her.
Is it her kind and friendly nature?
Some would call her ruthless. But is she wrong?
Life can be cruel. Perhaps she's right to embrace the cruelty. How goes the watch, Scudder?
A dull business, McCraith. But it is mine. I see you found yourself a gun.
Kate gave it to me.
I'll check, you know.
May I pass?
If Kate gave you her gun, I suppose you may pass. But I don't counsel it. Bad things happen in the woods. Only Thickskin walks safely out there.
You and Kate walk the woods yourselves, do you not?
Sometimes, and it's no gift. Kate's quick-tempered when she's not closed off. They say her heart broke once. It never mended.
Thank you for your time, Scudder. Good day to you.
See you again, McCraith. If you're lucky.
Behind Kate the Spitfire stands Kate the broken-hearted girl.
Hurt people hurt others. Happens every day.
Perhaps when this is over, she shall make peace with it. Target for your new toy. 10 guineas says you can't shoot as sweetly as you talk.
I shoot just fine, thank you very much. I am lucky. I'm also a phenomenal marksman. Both of these things are true.
So, where do we find this beast?
Not far from the missing settlers, I'll wager. Something's concealed. Fun.
Watch out! Spectre possession!
Think I used to count my wolf kills on one hand. Thank you.
That is quite the landslide.
No way in or out.
A mine. An old, abandoned mine. How wonderful.
And our only way through.
This one's protected. Try this on.
That beam is literally hanging by a thread. 20 guineas says you miss your first shot.
You're gonna owe me so much money. See? Easy.
Not so easy when the target fights back.
Get back up!
That specter's seen a corpse and it wants it for its own.
You're done. Why do I get the feeling that we have such ducks? Well, in we go then.
I love these old underground places.
I don't. Huska Castle nearly cost me an eye.
Investigating the cellar was your idea, remember? Daylight ahead.
I'll take it. Let's go.
Do you think this place is haunted?
I'd almost welcome the distraction. Seems to be stuck.
That cable seems to be holding the wagon in place.
Oh, shite! Bastard.
trouble's about.
We need to look for somewhere to cross. We need to look for somewhere to cross. The spot can't be far. The spot can't be far. I won't let you fall.
I know. Oh, I'm glad it's you throwing me around.
Happy to be of service. Strange tracks. Something passed this way. Something huge.
Hell, this is grim. If this keeps up, there won't be a wolf left in New England.
There might be a way to open this door from the other side. You need to see this. It forced its way through here, dug up all the wolves,
and plucked them out. If the beast did this, then it must be bloody enormous.
If the beast did this, then it must be corporeal. Not even the younglings survived.
What could have done this?
Vengeance. Vengeance incarnate. A memory ripples here. Whatever butchered the wolves spoke as one, with many voices.
Many spirits in borrowed flesh. Could it be a scourge?
Yes, a scourge. Powerful and very angry.
Bloody hell.
I'm right here, you know.
Closer than I would have liked.
That howl, like many souls screaming as one.